this faith.
Stuff?
Going not ready yet.
She's gonna go berserk.
After my coffee, Kato. Eh?
Kato, run out! Run out! Come up! Wil je koffie, Kato? Potje? Andere potje? Andere potje. Goed zo. Andere potje? Zo.
This is the last day that I can do it, so I woke up early and volunteered to walk the doggo in the morning in the forest. This place is so beautiful. I think I've always been a big city boy. I've wanted fast internet. I've wanted metros that stop near my house. Paris does all of that stuff for me, but just living this awesome forest life and having coffee in the morning, going back home and having another coffee with a little doggy, I started to have ideas of what I want as an adult. Friends that also have dogs and just walk the forest. Look at this one. And today's the day we go back to Paris. It's been a nice day here in the Netherlands and it's time to go back to Fatherland. My motherland is India. I was talking to someone who spoke Dutch. I was just gunning it, okay? I was like, okay, let's do this Dutch thing. And he asked me, what is your fatherland? I didn't get what he was saying because there were so many words in the sentence that I didn't understand. But he was talking about which is your home country. And it's interesting that they say fatherland in Dutch when they want to ask where's your homeland.
This is a place where I met an aged couple that I was talking about in the previous video. I met them here and... Hi, Kato. I met them here and their cute little dog. And I was listening to their story. They had an interesting story about their past and stuff, how they ended up in the Netherlands. He's from the south of France, how they decided to stay for almost 15 years in France and then their decision to move to the Netherlands. It was interesting to listen to these things. And their children had a lot to do with India. One of their son had moved to India for yoga and some other stuff.
Kato is such an industrious doggo. She can't sit still and waste time on a morning. So she's digging up a furrow and sitting in the furrow.
So I didn't come prepared for the cold. It was a sunny, sunny day in France. And also the weather forecast said it's sunny, gonna be sunny. The spring is set in. And all of a sudden it started getting so cold in the Netherlands and I had to borrow somebody else's coat because it's like 13 degrees in the morning and I just had a t-shirt and a couple of shirts and I needed like a little jacket. The Netherlands is cold all the time, much much colder than France. Sometimes they're similar, but general rule of thumb, if you're going to the Netherlands, pick up warm stuff even if it says it's going to be hot. One downpour of rain and 2 days of 13 degrees is expected. It's Dutch weather.
I think I'm a little late for the morning dog walkers crowd. It's 8:30 here and everyone's gone. I'm just next door so I can be home in 10 minutes. But for the others, I think they come really, even Kato for her morning walk, leaves home at like 6. And like at 7, 7:15 she's done. I've also noticed during my stay here in the Netherlands, I stayed in another part of the city before and it was not the best experience. I didn't make many friends and I was, yeah, I don't know, probably I was not ready myself. I don't know what it was, I can't put my finger on it. But just comparing, I don't want to say all of France, but definitely Paris to this city in the Netherlands, and I've also been to Amsterdam as a more confident, happy, less worried, less scared person now relative to when I came here first in 2017. Already I noticed that people in the Netherlands are far more open to talk to strangers, to have dogs. When you're walking around the place and you see someone and there is something in common, like your dog for example, if you have the same kind of jacket or the same shoe, even if there's not much in common, you can just say hello, how are you, or have a nice day when you walk away. More often than not, I've seen people engaging in conversation. Sometimes I don't understand the Dutch and then I have to ask what they said. In Paris, I don't think that's necessarily true. When you make friends, of course, they are. It's a different scenario in Paris. But just, you know, if you went to a coffee shop and you ordered a coffee, the guy won't make necessarily a joke. He'll just get you your coffee. He'll probably smile,
If you smile at him, he'll probably smile back. We went to have coffee the other day, and the server, she was new. So she was taking down notes, and I think she pointed out she was new. I don't remember. Of course, I didn't film it. But I don't think that would ever happen in Paris. Just having an extra conversation, which is not necessary, won't happen in Paris. You know, I mean, everyone agrees that it's not necessary, but it just makes the whole situation, it diffuses the situation, it breaks the ice. It feels a little human. You may never see this person, meet this person ever again in the future. But just a little joke, a little something to say, I think Netherlands is your place for that. But it's so cold throughout the year, I don't think I see myself settling in the Netherlands because of how cold it is. And rainy and windy it is, and not so sunny, and I need my vitamin D. So maybe a little sunnier place. But I don't know, if you do this too, every city I go to, I ask myself, do I see myself over here? Is that weird? Do you guys do that too? Yeah, I'd like to work over here one day.